Go ahead and give you a 2-minute warning on this. Today we're going to have our police chief, Jimmy Toller, from the Tyler Police Department speaking. Just so you have it for your records, that's Jimmy Toller, J-I-M-M-Y-T-O-L-E-R. So we'll get started here in about 2 minutes. tonight. If we're all ready, I'm going to go ahead and introduce our police chief, Jimmy Tobler.
Good afternoon. I want to thank all of you for being here. I want to say a special thank you to District Attorney Matt Bingham for being here with us today. Yesterday afternoon, Tyler Police Department investigators arrested William George Davis, Hallsville, Texas, on one count of murder. The warrant for murder was issued by Judge Jack Skeen, and a bond of $2 million was set. Davis is being charged with the death of a patient at the Christus Mother Francis Hospital, Tyler. The murder victim in this case is identified as Christopher Greenaway, age 47. Now, first and foremost, our thoughts and prayers go out to the families and the victim in this case and everyone that's affected. At the beginning of the investigation, Christus approached the Smith County District Attorney's Office and the Tyler Police Department with concerns that a nurse may have been involved in intentionally causing harm to patients at one of their hospitals. These patients were experiencing unexplained symptoms inconsistent with their treatment and recovery. The police department formed a criminal investigation team to investigate the reported incidents. The team included Assistant Chief Billy Yates, Lieutenant Paul Robeson, led by Sergeant Tommy Lewis, and Detectives Greg Roberts, Jeff Roberts, Craig Shine, and Ms. Melinda Weaver. These investigators have completed over 1,700 hours working on this investigation. I'm extremely proud of their effort and professionalism they've shown. As this case moves forward, we'll continue to dedicate the required personnel and resources as necessary. The speed and progress of this case would not have been possible without the help, cooperation, and professionalism of Christus and their staff. In addition, the support we've received from District Attorney Matt Bingham and his staff have been vital. We understand how big of an impact this investigation will have on our city and our community. As we move forward, we ask everyone to remember that this case remains an active and ongoing investigation. In an effort to protect the integrity of this investigation, we're limited in what we can share. However, we will provide updates and additional charges as we move forward and the details become available. We will take some questions, but we ask you just be respectful that we can't release all the details of the investigation. Well, we're happy to answer some questions today.
It sounds like there are more victims in the hospital investigated, at least two other patients, maybe three. So why only one of the charge, and what can you tell us specifically about that?
We've proceeded with this one charge at this time. When we file that charge with the district attorney's office, it's anticipated we'll file multiple aggravated assault charges on top of this one, and we are currently investigating up to 7 incidents at Christus.
Is there any indication that this nurse worked at other hospitals or other medical facilities in the area or elsewhere in the state of Texas or anywhere?
That is part of our investigation. As we go backwards from this point, they'll continue looking into any potential victims, and as that information comes to us, we'll look into each one of those incidents. But he has worked at this location for 5 years and another location for 2 years prior to this.
The hospital today said he worked there, as you said, back as far as 2013. You said up to 7 cases. Were all of those 7 cases at that facility, that hospital, Christus?
Yes.
Do you know how far back it goes?
We initiated this investigation that goes back till June of last year.
So all 7 were between now and June of last year?
Yes.
Is there any correlation or similarity between these patients, anything that ties them together in any way?
You know, some of the factors we look at during this investigation, there are some just being at the hospital, the type of procedures, but all that's included in the investigation. So going into additional details, we'll give out information we're not ready to release at this time.
As far as the murder charge is concerned, you say in layman's terms what he's accused of doing in terms of patient treatment?
You know, the specific method in which it occurred is also included in the investigation. So we don't want to, until we get all of them investigated and we let all that information out, as we go to trial, as we refer those cases to the district attorney's office and wait for additional information coming from experts, we'll look further at that, but we're not ready to release that at this time.
Can you make comment, though, on the way the Texas Board of Nursing described it in their court documents, where they had the three charges, the three patients that they were looking into, and with specifics to what it said about Mr. Greenaway's case, which was listed as charge one?
You know, that document was filed by, with the nursing board. We refer you to the nursing board for it.
But does their documents have any play in? Is it part of your investigation?
It is.
What they've done, what they've looked into?
Absolutely.
Can you kind of explain how all you guys kind of work together, like kind of timeline wise, when the hospital, when you had said the Christus approached Tyler PD, was one of two law enforcement agencies. Can you tell me when in the process that happened? Was it after the August incident, or was it after the most recent one? I guess it's the most recent one in January.
I believe they initiated contact in late January. We initiated our investigation early February. As we move forward, you know, as we do the analysis, as they do their internal reviews, and we start to recognize these patterns, then we move forward to investigation at that point, and we've been working continuously since that point in early February.
Could you talk a little bit more about the cooperation, the fact that they brought it to you, and how the hospital has been working with you, and how that relationship has developed over the time?
You know, as we move forward, everybody knows that as we file grand jury subpoenas or other civil procedure, that some of these could take months sometimes to get the records and the information they need. With the help of the district attorney's office, the grand jury subpoenas, cooperation with Christus at their location, they expedited those and got us the information we needed. In instances that normally would take months, we got that information in days.
Can you confirm that only one of the cases being investigated resulted in death?
And at this time, yes, ma'am.
So the other six, just to further her point, they have not died. It's just Mr. Greenaway.
At this point, any additional charges we file would be for aggravated assault, meaning a serious bodily injury was caused to the victim.
Have the families in the other cases been notified?
We have spoken with and interviewed all the family members in reference to this case, and have made contact with them again last night after the arrest was made.
Can you talk about the arrest? How about, I'm sure you had to know he was under investigation. How did that come down? How was he brought into custody?
Yeah, actually he was arrested here in the lobby of the police department last night.
Turned himself in?
He came up here to pick up some information, or some evidence that was going to be released to him. At that point, he was taken into custody.
Thought that was the safest way to,
yes,
bring him in.
Absolutely.
Has he said anything in his own defense or about these allegations when he was arrested?
You know, any additional statements made by him would be included in the investigation, and we'll refer that to the district attorney's office. And as it proceeds, goes to the grand jury process, into trial, a lot of that information will come out at that point.
Can you maybe describe, maybe your phone's been ringing today. We're from Shreveport. Our newsroom is ringing. We got emails from people, hey, my loved one died in that hospital in 2016. I believe our sister station here in Tyler, similar circumstances. Have you had a number of calls like that? Have you had other people, once the news got out, that they've been calling you and this department with concerns about their own loved ones?
We have had an increase in calls today with concerns from family members. I know Christus has set up a hotline. We'll get that information out to you. And also, if you call here, we'll get you some information to call if you have some concerns or questions. As that information comes in, we'll look at each one of them individually.
Is it safe to say that the suspect or the accused is being cooperative to some extent?
No, sir.
I'm just, again, trying to get you to just, if you can help me understand, do you feel like he was targeting patients to kill them?
You know, I think a lot of that information will come out during the investigation. There's multiple outcomes that he did. That's intent, and that'll have to come out later through either expert testimony or his actual words themselves. But we're not able to say that at this point. All we can say is that his actions caused these injuries.
Are there any other persons of interest at this time?
You know, I will say that we only had one person of interest in this case, and that person is now in custody. And that, again, I want to stress the cooperation and the level of commitment from the DA's office and Christus has been extremely beneficial during this investigation. And there's no reason for us to believe that there was anyone else associated with these injuries.
Any kind of criminal passed?
No, sir. I appreciate y'all coming in today. There will be additional information provided to y'all as we file additional charges. As we refer these cases to the district attorney's office for further prosecution, there will be additional information coming from his office at a later date. So I do want to appreciate every one of you for coming up today, because we understand how important this is to our community. We understand the impact being a medically based community like we are, and having such a major role in here, that we take these cases very serious, and that we do everything we can to make sure that justice is served in this one.
Have you ever had a case this big before that had, you know, so much attention, regional attention such as this one?
You know, we are in Tyler and in Smith County, and we've had some pretty significant cases over the years.
But
this is the most recent.
Even the manpower that you've put into it.
We have had cases that have required this much manpower before.
Could you just to clarify, 7 cases total, including the murder charge, or are you looking at 7 additional?
There are 7 individuals that we're examining their cases. Mm-hmm. The murder charge is included in that.
Thank you all for being here today. Media partners, if you didn't sign in, please go ahead and sign in or get with me before you leave. Any additional information, we'll be sending it out digitally, so you can contact me. My name is Jenny Wells, I'm the PIO. My number is 903-944-9136. You can reach us via email or my cell phone, and then any other questions, we'll field that way. So thank you for being here today. We appreciate your time.